हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज शिवांगी। आई रीड इन 10th क्लास ऑफ आर्यपाल भारती पब्लिक स्कूल। आई एम गिविंग अ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम। ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम कंसिस्ट ऑफ एलिमेंट्री कैनल एंड इट एसोसिएटेड ग्लैंड्स। द वेरियस सिस्टम ऑफ ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम आर माउथ, ओसोफेगस, स्टमक, स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन एंड लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन। ग्लैंड्स और एसोसिएटेड्स आर लीवर, पैनक्रियास एंड सलाइवरी ग्लैंड्स। द ह्यूमन एलिमेंट्री कैनल्स कंसिस्ट विच रन्स फ्रॉम माउथ टू एनस एंड इट्स अबाउट 9 meter लॉन्ग ट्यूब एंड इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड गट्स। वेरियस स्टेप्स इन ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम आर इंजेशन, डाइजेशन, एब्जॉर्प्शन, एसिमिलेशन एंड इजेशन। द फर्स्ट स्टेप इज ingestion. When we ingested the food into the mouth with the help of our hands. The second step is digestion. The process of digestion is started in mouth. We use teeth for breakdown of food. Salivary gland produce saliva, which is watery liquid, and wet the food. Small pieces of food and saliva, and we use tongue to mix it. We can easily swallow this resultant mixture. Saliva contains enzymes which convert into starch and carbohydrates into sugar form. When the food is swallowed, then it goes to food pipe. Food pipe is also known as oesophagus. Oesophagus take this food to stomach and digest it. Take food for 3 to 4 hours and digest it. The glands present on the stomach produce gastric juice. This juice contains 3 substances: hydrochloric acid, pepsin enzymes, and mucus. The main work in this is of pepsin enzymes, which digest protein and convert it into smaller molecule. Hydrochloric acid, it is the acidic in nature, which makes the gastric juice acidic, so that the enzymes pepsin can digest the property into small molecules and it kills the bacteria which may enter the stomach. Mucus, it is protect the inner lining of the stomach for the action of hydrochloric acid, and it partially digested food then goes from stomach to the small intestine in small amount. The small intestine is about 6.5 meter long and it is the largest part of alimentary canal. It is the site of complete digestion of the food. The digestion is complete into the small intestine. The final digestion of carbohydrates, fats and proteins are done in it. Liver and pancreas are connected to small intestine. Liver produces a substance which is named as bile and stored in gallbladder. Bile is nature in alkaline and it contains salt which breaks the fat into small amount for enzymes to digest it. These enzymes comes from pancreas in small intestine and works in alkaline medium. Pancreatic juice enters from pancreas to small intestine which contains 3 enzymes: amylase, trypsin and lipase. Amylase breaks starch and carbohydrates, trypsin breaks proteins, lipase breaks fats, and which complex carbohydrates into glucose and protein into amino acid and fats into glycerol or fatty acid, and this digestion is completed and body convert large insoluble substance into small water soluble molecules. Why is this very long process in our body? It is because the final production of glucose, amino acid and glycerol to spread all different organs of the body where they stored in cells which are used in energy, growth and repair. These products are mixed in the third step, which is absorption. The inner surface of the small intestine has finger-like projection called villi, and hence result is very large surface area. The large surface area of small intestine helps to rapid absorption of digested food. The fourth step is assimilation. The blood carries digested food to all parts of body where it becomes assimilated as part of cell. The assimilated food is used up by the body cells for obtaining energy for growth and for repair of body. The remaining glucose is stored in skeletal muscles and live in it the form of muscles and leave it in the form of carbohydrate called glycogen. This stored glycogen give energy to the body when required. The last step is ingestion. It is the part of undigested food which cannot be absorbed in small intestine, passes into the wider tube called large intestine. The walls of the large intestine absorb most of the water from the undigested food with the help of villi. Due to this, undigested food become almost solid. Last part of the large intestine is rectum. It stored this undigested food for some time. This undigested food is passed out from our body through anus and feces or stool. The process of excrete the feces or stool is called ingestion. Thank you.